What did you do to change things here this tournament?
I mean, I really didn't do anything. I mean, it's kind of fell a point for me after we beat OpTic at Columbus. And, I mean, I don't want to say anything got boring, but I was just kind of focusing on other things. But, I mean, coming to this event, the World Championship's coming up, biggest event of the year, definitely something I want to get my second ring in. You know, I'd have two more than Nate shot. But, you know, nothing really changed, just wanting to prove myself this tournament.
Well, there you have it already, some trash talk coming out of Aches.
Rivalries can be created any number of ways, but the ones that rise to the top are unique.
Sorry, George, but we're likely going to win, just like every other time.
They are built by the community and are sustained by the passion of fans on both sides. And while rivalries sometimes feature teams that are vastly divergent, it seems like the greatest ones feature opponents that are more alike than they are different.
Constantly being distracted. Oh! Oh! The disrespect!
That, after all, is the story of OpTic Gaming and FaZe Clan. In 2006, Ryan, OpTic J, Musselman formed a North American Call of Duty 2 clan that went by OpTic Gaming. This early team had the same goals as any FPS clan at the time would, namely proving their excellence against the other players online.
Oh. Can't mess with this natural talent, though. Oh, you see that? I don't need no scope.
The team eventually caught the attention of Hector Hex Rodriguez, who had started to feel dissatisfied with his job in the mortgage industry and had purchased an Xbox on a whim as a way to unwind after a long day at work. When he saw how good one of OpTic's members was firsthand, Hex quickly realized that he was part of a clan and followed them around to different online lobbies, beating them constantly. Learning that OpTic competed on a tournament website called Next Gamers, Hex volunteered for the site as a referee and eventually got to know OpTic J. Soon enough, Hex was invited to join the clan, and when OpTic J left the game in 2007, Hex would become his replacement. Hex's brother Pedro, better known as OpTic Tumors, would then suggest something that changed the course of OpTic forever. The team should buy a capture card and start uploading their footage to YouTube. Working for insurance company AIG in 2009, Hex was confronted with the possibility of layoffs as the United States government bailed out much of the financial sector in the aftermath of the mortgage crisis. With his wife Judith 7 months pregnant, Hex made a decision that would change the rest of his life. He quit his job to focus on OpTic full time. OpTic 2 made some changes, and it was once again Tumors who made the suggestion. The clan added a sniper team, becoming what Hex called the first ever legitimate sniper clan in the process. Members would use only bolt-action sniper rifles that couldn't say no to challenges from other players. While OpTic may have inspired other sniper clans, they had one hell of a head start, and Hex aimed to keep the clan ahead of its competition. With the goal of releasing a Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 montage before the game's release, he bought an illegal Xbox and recorded footage of a pirated copy of the game. The resulting video not only helped catapult OpTic into the minds of COD fans, but it has since become a near legendary part of the game's history. In fact, OpTic's popularity as a sniper clan and montage video channel was so widespread that there was some protest from within the clan when Hex decided to restart the team's competitive wing in 2010. But after a disastrous initial outing at Frag Cup 1, the organization went on to assemble a competitive roster that included the likes of Merc, Vengeance, Flawless, and Nadeshot. While OpTic's journey into eSports was beginning in earnest, FaZe Clan had just formed. The sniping clan started in May 2010, and they were already trying new things that would change the perception of what exactly a sniper clan was. A big part of this was trickshotting, which added things like rapid rotations, weapon switching, and no-scoping to the more familiar quick-scoping videos. FaZe also began a series called Ill Cams, which showcased trick shots performed as part of a round-winning kill, earning the end of the game kill cam. The series is the longest running on FaZe Clan's YouTube channel, with 50 installments so far. Meanwhile, OpTic's esports squad took fourth at MLG Dallas. This event was where the now famous green wall term was coined because, as Hex tells it, the support staff standing in the uniform near the team essentially formed a green wall. But MLG Dallas was also important for FaZe, as they met Hex and received a shout out from him, which they also posted on YouTube.
What up, guys? Big up to Hex. I'm here with my boys from FaZe Sniper. I know where you guys are.
OpTic was moving ahead in the still uncertain world of COD esports. Developer support for the esports scene was unclear at this early stage, and the prize pools were not massive. OpTic won $500 for placing fourth at Dallas. Though OpTic's early teams weren't yet dominant, the fans they had built through YouTube continued to support their efforts. For the moment, FaZe stuck to YouTube, and while a rivalry between the two clans already existed online, Dallas was the first time that the rivalry entered a public arena. In some ways, FaZe's model was much the same. Produce entertaining video content about Call of Duty and give the players generating that content a chance to self-promote on their own channels. In short, while they could coexist, they were essentially fighting over the same digital turf and were competing for a similar demographic on YouTube. But there were also more concrete examples of beef between FaZe and OpTic at the early stage, especially online. OpTic continued to work on improving their esports fortunes, all the while continuing to upload videos to their channel. While OpTic had won MLG Columbus in 2011, their biggest break yet would come at Call of Duty XP 2011. The idea was for Activision to show a new devotion to COD esports, and the event itself was very high profile for its time as it featured $1 million in prize money and a post-tournament concert by Kanye West. OpTic's win at COD XP and the $400,000 grand prize helped to raise the team's profile. The rest of 2011 and 2012 would see OpTic establish a pattern of strong competitive finishes, as they took first at MLG Orlando 2011, EGL 7, and UMG Chicago 2012. While OpTic were making waves in the competitive scene, FaZe were building a competitive roster of their own, assembling Heist, Methods, Replays, and Embos to compete at the MLG Winter Championship 2013. However, that team failed to win a series outside the open bracket, and never played against OpTic, who placed 6th at the event. It also meant that FaZe was left out of the Call of Duty Championship 2013, while OpTic went on to place 3rd. The two teams would meet again at MLG Anaheim 2013.
OpTic versus FaZe, the biggest game you could imagine. I can't wait to see the Twitter poll. It is going to explode. They both have huge individual fan bases.
And again, OpTic would go on to best FaZe.
Right here, Heslin is going to be inside of the statue. He gets one kill. Wait for someone on the right side.
There we go. It's mathematically impossible.
It moves on to the next round.
Huge plays right there at the very end, coming from Merc. Nature once again on a 5 streak. Unbelievable breaking of hard points there from OpTic Gaming. FaZe were in complete control, and out of nowhere, OpTic, they just went huge.
Round of applause for Nate's shot. That was a heck of a game. He broke that hill so many times. He established so much control. OpTic Gaming, phenomenal performance.
The next time the two organizations clashed at a major event was UMG Philadelphia 2014. FaZe's roster consisted of Replays, Classic, JCap, and Methods, and they were set to face off against OpTic's lineup of Nadeshot, Big Timer, Skump, and Ricky. Big Timer had already announced he would retire after the event, but the series still went a full and thrilling 5 games.
We have one player left alive, 3 seconds left. Ricky can't Ricky do it, and FaZe will have taken the W in what an amazing game from both teams. Hey,
holy moly.
When it all comes down to it, you just gotta do what you gotta do.
Wow. Oh my god. What a game.
What a game. FaZe.
What a game.
Ends up taking it in a nail-biting matchup here.
I just like to say. Hold it.
It was one of FaZe's first big wins against OpTic.
During that matchup, we actually started off pretty slow. We went down 0-2.
It wasn't looking good, but we were able to bring it back, and we actually won the series 3-2.
But they only managed to place top 8 at the event, which was outside the money. In terms of overall success though, OpTic had great placements in late 2012 and most of 2013 under their belts. Heading into 2014, FaZe were still trying to find their stride. They did eventually start to find it as they brought on Proofy, and at the COD Championships 2014 US Regionals, the team went further in the bracket than OpTic, but both squads qualified for the main events. When the chips were down, OpTic went further than FaZe, earning 3rd place and the accompanying $120,000 prize, while FaZe had to settle for 6th place. While FaZe were not dominant during this period, they were starting to earn more consistent results, which meant that the two teams would have more opportunities to clash. OpTic 2 were not considered to be a top-tier squad, but both teams had some victories as 2014 unfolded. FaZe won COD League Season 1's regular season, while OpTic won gold at the X Games.
Make a plan here, and he knows that too. Glacier and Gujar look like they might meet up here in a second.
Glaze got the better weaponry as well. This Bulldog up close could be devastating. Gujar running out of time.
He can't plant now. He doesn't have enough time to plant. So he's got to get the kill. Gujar's got to find Glacier. Glacier's going to look. And he gets the kill. And OpTic Gaming wins it. OpTic Gaming, your X Games gold medal champion.
And it was made all the sweeter by the fact that OpTic's Nadeshot was finally able to triumph over Aches.
God, because that was the biggest rivalry for us, dude. Aches always kicked OpTic's ass for whatever reason. He just always beat us. And we finally took him down.
FaZe would add their first major event victory at UMG Nashville 2014, where they reset the bracket from losers and took both series 3-2.
Apathy taken out as well. Karma trying to get on the rotation. He has Sensor in front of him. Sensor takes out Saints, and it was all up to replays in a 2-on-1.
The full plays are right in front of him right here. They're playing this trade perfectly, and sure enough, it's double team. FaZe takes UMG.
FaZe is your UMG Nashville Elgato 25K champions.
Suddenly, the possibility of OpTic and FaZe fighting at the highest level seemed plausible. While Aches had been vanquished at the X Games, he would return to haunt OpTic at the end of 2014. As Advanced Warfare released and MLG Columbus 2014 got underway, this time, instead of Complexity or Evil Geniuses, it was on FaZe.
We decided to add Aches to our team, so it's me, Apathy, and Aches looking for one, and I know it sounds absolutely crazy. It's something that a lot of people didn't expect.
At Columbus, the rivalry took another step forward. Not only did the two teams play each other in the grand finals, but Aches brought his pre-existing enmity with not only OpTic, but Nadeshot, and Crimzix in particular, into the story of OpTic and FaZe.
We're gonna win 3-0. Ooh, winning it 3-0. Aches, back to you. What are you gonna think?
5-0. Backing up to some support.
That was a huge play, but Slasher has gone down. That's Nadeshot with the kill. 3 versus 3. Time is ticking. Oh, Sensor! He's just going to kill a bubble game by a second. Sensor! Unbelievable play. That leaves Nadeshot 1-on-3. He's going to get the kill, though. 29 seconds left. Bomb down. Can he stay alive? Nadeshot, no! FaZe win the championship. Sensor, an unbelievable play.
Not only did FaZe beat OpTic, but coming from loser's bracket meant that they had to reset the bracket and win 2 best of 5s to do it. While it's easy to view this as a big win for FaZe, it was also the first time that the two organizations would meet in the grand finals of an event of this magnitude. That did a lot to legitimize the rivalry in a competitive scene. OpTic may have had to settle for second at the beginning of Advanced Warfare, but they fielded one of their most dominant rosters during the rest of the year. At MLG Pro League Season 1, they won both the season and the playoffs. They then won the NA Regional Finals for the COD 2015's champs, but failed to win the event proper, going out at 7th place. After Nadeshot stepped down, using Enable as a sub and then adding Karma, they continued their dominance. Like JCAP before him, Enable would cross the lines of battle, joining FaZe after his short stint as a sub with OpTic. If fans of both teams weren't aware of the rivalry before 2015, that was the year it truly came into its own. For most of the year, OpTic appeared unbeatable, but when they did lose, the only team that seemed to be able to best them at the majors was FaZe. It was almost like the tension between the two organizations and their fan bases brought out the best in FaZe. At UMG Dallas 2015, FaZe won a thrilling grand finals series against OpTic, and that win was made all the more satisfying by FaZe's addition of Clayster, who had previously been a member of OpTic Gaming.
Can just pick it up and play for 15, it will be GG. There's only 15 seconds left in, and OpTic needs to go for 2 2-point plays. Formal's gonna die, and that looks as if it's gonna be that. Karma, last man up. FaZe are gonna take the UMG Dallas grand final 3-0.
Then, less than a month later, they did it to OpTic again at the Gfinity Summer Championship.
Two, Zuma and Attach.
It's a 2v1, actually, Bryce. It's going to be Karma, last one alive.
That's it.
And that is it. FaZe is going to win your Summer 100K Championship for Gfinity.
OpTic were no strangers to rivalries. They had the E Classico with Team Envious, and Complexity and later Evil Geniuses had proven to be hard-fought opponents for much of the team's history. But by September 2015, it was clear that despite all that, the rivalry with FaZe was something special. Attach, a member of the competitive roster at the time, called it the new rivalry, and it ended up spilling into the team's online games as well.
As I was saying, FaZe and OpTic are two of the top teams in competitive Call of Duty right now. This has not really happened before. FaZe and OpTic have not always been like the best or considered the best at the same time in a real game. In this game, Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, it's kind of been back and forth.
Almost as soon as Attach had pointed out the rivalry's growing impact, FaZe struck again, this time beating OpTic in the COD Pro League Season 3 playoffs.
So many explosive barrels. He does manage to get away. 2v3 though, in favor of FaZe. Formal sneaks behind one, makes it a 2v2. Formal and Crimp going up against Attach and Zuma. 56 seconds left in the round, and Formal is being desperately chased. He needs to be careful here because both players from FaZe are right on his tail. Formal surely dead to rights. Attach. Oh, don't get turned on. Surely not. No. Picks up the kill now. A 1v2.
The shot caller in a 1v2. 39 seconds remain. And Krim is going to get finished. FaZe will take your Season 3 championship.
Again, it was from Loser's Bracket, and again, they reset to win both Best of 7 series 4-1. OpTic would get the last laugh in Advanced Warfare, as they took the MLG World Finals.
Stun, hitting Formal, Formal forced to back up, Karma trying to back him up here with a sniper, but not the angle he wanted. Krim, 10 kills already, is he going to find number 11?
Big kill comes in from Karma, it's essentially a 1v3 for Temp, tournament life on the line, and he goes down!
OpTic Gaming has done it again, Ben!
The release of Black Ops 3 and the rise of the Call of Duty World League meant a more structured year for COD esports. But FaZe started to lag behind OpTic, and there were fewer opportunities for them to play spoiler as a result. OpTic had another impressive year, winning both the Stage 1 regular season and playoffs, Crown Melbourne Invitational, ESWC 2016, and MLG Opens at both Anaheim and Orlando. While the rivalry still raged on in the hearts of both teams' fans, it did not grace the stage as often as both sides may have wanted. But the seeds had already been sown in another first-person shooter, Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Both teams had entered the game in January 2016. FaZe had purchased a CSGO roster from G2 Esports, considered to be one of the game's best at that time. And rather than buying an EU roster, OpTic elected to sign Conquest, a North American roster that had formed in summer 2015.
The decision that I was going to have to make was pretty much to go against the OpTic culture. I was going to have to acquire a team from Europe and have little to no contact with them.
Though both games are first-person shooters, the fan bases of Call of Duty and CSGO did not always overlap, and the two esports had developed in very different ways. The two teams did not have many high-profile meetings until late in the year, first facing off in the semifinals at the E-League Season 2 Finals.
A single kill away from that Grand Finals.
And now he has no idea where they're playing from either. Although the pre-fire through the smoke, unbelievable. Not gonna get it, Kerrigan! It was so close! But Nafly will do it, he gets the final kill.
After that meeting, Hex told OpTic that if they went up against FaZe at ECS Season 2 and won, he would chip in his share of the winnings, which the team actually did. Late 2016 saw the rivalry flare up again, and it was a familiar situation. The first major event of a new game, Infinite Warfare, saw a classic FaZe OpTic matchup in the loser's bracket at the CWL Las Vegas Open. Neither team went on to win the entire tournament, but in a heart-pounding series, FaZe once again played spoiler.
Woo-hoo-hoo! This rivalry makes me happy to be an American.
FaZe may have won some of the battles, but OpTic won the war. They would go on to defeat FaZe at the Call of Duty World Championship, winning $600,000, the single biggest prize in the organization's history in the process.
You are going all in here on uplink. You are trying to get the one-point play, then get back for the camo play. OpTic Gaming, our top three, and into Championship Sunday.
The rivalry has continued outside of the game as well. Both organizations have continued to produce YouTube content, much of it with no esports focus at all. But the lines drawn between the two fan bases have put some former esports pros in awkward positions.
But you guys got to understand this. Me, Matthew Haig, as a person, I'm friends with the guys in FaZe Clan. I'm not friends with Rain. I'm not friends with Temper. I'm not friends with Blaziken or Tico. I'm friends with them as people, as Norton, as Tommy, as Lucas, and Jacob. Like, I'm friends with them just as individuals.
Nadeshot, formerly part of one of OpTic's most successful rosters, caught flack from his own fanbase for making videos about hanging out with members of FaZe. Though he wasn't surprised that some fans were unhappy with it, the scale and severity of the backlash did.
It was pretty mind-blowing to me how many people were upset that I was hanging out with people from FaZe Clan, but I understand where they're coming from. I mean, it'd be like me, or it'd be like a Cavs fan wearing a Warriors jersey at Oracle Arena watching them play. I understand it. But maybe people were taking it a little too far, dude. They're especially leaving too many dislikes on my videos. That kind of hurt me.
Like most things in esports, the future of the rivalry is uncertain. OpTic has since expanded to both League of Legends and Overwatch, earning a spot in both games' franchise leagues. They've also picked up a Dota 2 roster. On the flip side, FaZe has an Overwatch team, but was not part of the initial 12 Overwatch League teams. No doubt, COD fans will keep the spirit of this storied rivalry alive, and CS fans could eventually embrace it. Whether it is something that can spread to other esports is still up in the air. In a way, the OpTic FaZe rivalry mirrors their origin on YouTube. As OpTic got out to a head start, FaZe was there, pushing hard for the same audience. Both FaZe and OpTic started their esports journeys with established fan bases. Instead of adding them solely through winning, they were built on the raw but hardest passion of their respective supporters. That passion fostered something that, once both teams formed competitive rosters, was unlike anything in esports. And despite OpTic's golden age in 2015 and 2016, FaZe was always there to keep them honest, and occasionally take the W away.
FaZe jump now! FaZe win the championship! Sensor, an unbelievable play!
What a comeback! FaZe had to do it twice, two best of fives!
Whether you're part of the green wall or you FaZe up, the rivalry taught us that the most loyal fans you can have are the ones who were with you even before you started winning, when YouTube brought millions of console gamers together in the pursuit of the sickest montage and the craziest no-scope.